Life and Death Row has got an insight into exactly that, stateside, here on 3 in an hour. Got to get ourselves our precious dose of Don't Tell the Bride first, though, right?
From the depths of the earth. You know, baby,
when you're in my arms. So, all change next tonight, loves. He's killed 8 members of his family, and now he's on trial for his life. All that, and still only 26 years old. Life and Death Row, here on 3, right after 60 seconds.
Hi, I'm Sam. It's 9 o'clock. Time for a quick update. Sunderland footballer Adam Johnson's pleaded guilty to one count of sexual activity with a child. He appeared at Bradford Crown Court. The winger denies 2 other charges. Junior doctors in England are on strike over new contracts. Talks between their union and the government broke down. Nearly 3,000 non-emergency ops have been cancelled. They helped a teenager travel to Syria to join Islamic State fighters. 3 men have been jailed under terror laws. They got around 5 years each. These Liverpool fans left the match early in protest over rising ticket prices. Some were £77. Now the club's made a U-turn. The top price will be £59. And Beth Tweddle's taken her first step since having neck surgery. The Olympic gymnast was injured in a fall on Channel 4's The Jump. Her parents say doctors are pleased with her progress. We'll stay with 3 now for Life and Death Row.
I don't think it's what many people would deem as being homeless.
There's a forgotten part of society.
Well, me, yeah, they don't want people like me here anymore. They price us out. They don't want your standard guy.
Professor Green looks at youth homelessness and asks, are we creating a lost generation?
This is not a quality of life. It's not living, it's existing. It is like a completely separate world. And it's weird because they coexist. The other one's just up there.
Professor Green, Hidden and Homeless, available now on BBC iPlayer.
Wednesday night, and we've got a couple of Russell Howards on the way, here from 20 past 10. First, with some strong language and scenes which some viewers may find disturbing. Another insight from 3 into Life and Death Row.
Colonel Lowe?
Yes.
The witnesses are now entering the witness room. At this time, the condemned has declined to make a last statement.
If it's possible.
There's actually brand new stuff coming from this series when we move online. Check out what's coming up in just a sec.
I saw the foreman handing over the paper, and her hand was shaking.
I think maybe Daniel should have died that night. It's like you're having a funeral over and over again.
We can't have people like that in our community. He's got a track record of other crimes.
There is a human life that is hanging in the balance.
The BAFTA award-winning Life and Death Row returns online from Tuesday, 16th of February on BBC Three.
Hi, I'm Sam. Here's our check on the global news channels. GMA called it a political earthquake. They said US presidential hopefuls Bernie Sanders and Donald Trump won big in the first votes. Trump live on NBC told them it felt great. Fox said it was a crushing loss for Hillary Clinton, while CNN had the breaking news Trump's rival Chris Christie is expected to bow out of the race. Germany's ZDF said there's still no word on what caused the deadly train crash, but local news in Bayern speculated a line controller turned off a safety system. France's BFM reporting 2 children killed in a school bus crash. LCI reckon it was going too fast in the snow. They said the driver's been detained by police. And an unusual story on Florida's WPTV. The man who threw an alligator through a fast food drive-through window. He's ended up in court and told the channel it's probably the last time he'll do it. More from us later. Russell Howard's up next.
We're here to interview a female who alleges she's been a missing persons for the last 13 years.
You believe me, don't you?
Reports that their daughter Ivy, snatched as a 13-year-old in 2003, has been found alive.
Ivy.
You're okay, please.
You just need to hear some time. Oh, Mum, sorry. But that girl isn't her.
13. Coming soon online to BBC Three.
It's all about the doubles, it seems, tonight on Three. Family Guy with two in a row, back to back, here later. And now, well, yeah, another double. Russell Howard's turn. And this one contains some strong language and adult humour.